best trick ever.
Thursday weekend, I think I had the best Monday ever. I just had to come home on Sunday and sleep.
I'm ready to go back.
And just go home and sleep.
I thought it was my 3 months of no sleep.
Good morning, and thank you for tuning in to the Live and Five show, where we are living live.
The Tesla band takes first place in their first parade. We have all the details coming up.
Yay, good job, Tesla band. Anyways, there are a lot of games and some exciting news for the Lakers. You'll find out more about that.
Have you ever dreamed about controlling a giant robot? Well, there are some people who actually can. More details on the way.
Finally, it's cooling down the way it's supposed to be.
Oh no, the book fair is gone, but you can still order all of this and more on the other side of the break.
Hurricane Katrina is now a Category 5 hurricane heading toward New Orleans. All citizens are urged to move to a safe location as soon as possible. This is a very dangerous storm.
Hello, I'm Jewel Parker Rhodes, author of Ninth Ward. In 2005, when Hurricane Katrina hit, I was transfixed by news stories and images of the survivors. I immediately thought, what about the children? That night, I went to bed, and I had terrifying dreams. But I woke up with Lanisha's voice inside my head, and she was ready to tell me a story about how she survived, how she was brave and resilient. This is a levee meant to hold back floodwaters. When Hurricane Katrina hit, the levees broke, and water surged into the Ninth Ward community. The floodwaters rose quickly, and people couldn't escape. 7 years later, and you can still see the destruction left by Hurricane Katrina. Lanisha would have lived in a house like this. One day she'd be swinging on her porch, playing with friends, and the next day the hurricane would come, the waters would rise, and everything would be destroyed. Ninth Ward has sad moments, but it isn't a sad story. Just as the levees break, life can sometimes seem unbearable. But Lanisha's story is one of hope and inspiration. She does triumph. It's a wonderful, particular New Orleans story. As Mama Yaya tells Lanisha, the universe always shines down with love.
Pick up a copy of Jewel Parker Rhodes' Ninth Ward at your Scholastic Book Fair and experience this emotional story of surviving one of the worst storms in U.S. history.
Dedicate today's show to all who are serving and have served in the Armed Forces of the United States. We salute you and honor you. Thank you for defending the freedom and privilege of the living in this country. We are grateful. Happy Veterans Day.
Tesla Band and Color Guard win sweepstakes in Saturday's parade. That's first place for both sections, and it was their first parade of the year. It all took place at our neighboring city, La Palma, and although Tesla have the size of its it didn't keep them from measuring up. Congratulations are also in order for Mr. Gullett, the new band teacher, and Mrs. whoever her name is, for leading them. Well done, Trojans.
The book fair is gone, but be sure to stop in online into the online book fair to pick out a favorite selection of books for a great price. A proportion of the funds go to help the library. Check it out anywhere today and tomorrow.
International Society members, there is a meeting at room 301 today during lunch. Again, International Society members will meet in room 301 at lunch.
Are you interested in hanging out with UCLA students? Do you want to talk about what it's like to go to college? Would you like the UCLA students to help you with your homework? Are you a SHAPE member? If you answer yes to all these questions, make sure you attend SHAPE today after school in room 103.
BJ's fundraiser is taking place tomorrow, so save your flyers and see you there.
The principal's challenge is still here. The book you must read is The Lightning Thief by Rick Riordan. When you take the AR quiz and get 85% or higher, you will be rewarded with a movie day and treats. Stop by the library and get the book today. Time now to cross the globe with Dylan. Good morning, Dylan.
Good morning, Janaya. Have you ever imagined being able to control a giant robot that's over 13 feet tall? This gigantic robot suit was invented by Kurogo Kurata and Wataru Yoshizaki. Japanese robotics presented the giant robot to the public on July 29th. These two inventors created the machine to run on diesel fuel and reach a top speed of 6.2 miles per hour. In addition, they added and built in a BB gun as a potential weapon, which can fire 6,000 BB rounds per minute. Just for fun, they also included a water balloon launcher on a Tsubasa Heavy Industry website. This amazing invention is sold online to buyers who can even customize their personal robot suit. This robot is so expensive. People will not be seeing it in the streets just yet. That wraps up the news around the world. Time to go back to Tesla for upcoming events.
Thank you, Dylan. Looking at the Tesla calendar, today's International Society will be meeting at lunch, then after school, Shape meets in room 103. The science department will be selling snacks and Juice It Up is selling smoothies. Tomorrow's Spirit Day and after school, the science department is selling snacks and it's game day at Fetty for the football and volleyball teams. Don't forget to visit BJ's on 183rd with the flyers to help raise money for the PE department. Thursday after school, the science department is back selling snacks again, and Juice It Up will be there. The cross-country team will be practicing. Finally, Friday is a minimum day and college day, and that takes care of a Tesla calendar. Time now for your 11.5 forecast.
Here, see? I just want to take this moment to give a shout out to all the men and women that are serving for our country and who did. Thank you very much. As we can see, today we are cooling down with 70s all down the west and some in the 50s up north, like Seattle, will see 50 with some rain, a rainstorm. Go down to the south, we see they're cooling it down with 50s to 60s and some winds. Sorry, I can see there. And then east is also cooling down with 48 in Norfolk. Now right up here, let's go to our 5-day forecast. Today looks like it's going to be a beautiful day of 74, and along with tomorrow is 74, and Wednesday is going to be 71. It'll cool down to Thursday with 70 and a possible chance of rain. And Friday, it looks like it's going to cool, warm just up a little bit with 74 and partial cloudy. That wraps up here. Let's go to Jefferson with the web poll. Good morning, Jefferson.
Good morning, Kyla. For this week's web poll, we have Aaron with us. Good morning, Aaron.
Hello there, sir.
Will you please read this week's web poll?
Okay. Should large sugary drinks be banned in California?
Here's what you told us, Trojans. Yes, because sugary drinks are full of sugar. Another one of you said no, because people should be able to buy sugary drinks whenever they want. We want to hear from you. Be sure to visit us online at liveandfashion.com or Facebook page to vote. Send your comments to webpoll@liveandfashion.com, and if it's good, we'll read on air. So, Aaron, what do you think?
I think that we should, because people will get more obese, and then people could get diabetes.
Want to give a shout-out to anyone?
Yeah, I want to give a shout-out to Miss Kitty Gallus' homeroom, all my homies, and then especially Mario.
And I want to give a shout-out to all the veterans, and now let's go to Mario with the Live in 5 Sports.
Thank you, Aaron and Jefferson. Well, Pittsburgh beat Kansas City 16-13. Houston beat Chicago 13-6. Dallas beat Philadelphia 38-24. And thanks to the loss of Michael Vick with the concussion, everybody said put in the backup quarterback for Michael Vick. Look at him now. This isn't college anymore. Wow, amazing. Baltimore beat Oakland 55-20. That's a shutdown. Now for your NBA. Utah and Toronto went into a triple overtime, and Utah won 144-133. Did you hear about the big news in LA? Wow, they fired Mike Brown and hired Mark D'Antoni. Apparently, Apparently, he was surprised that he got the job over Phil Jackson. Yet he told New York Daily News that he assumed, like everybody else, Jackson was looking to return Mike Brown's replacement. Brown was fired after the Lakers stumbled badly out of the gate when he was struggling to learn his Princeton inflected offense and playing the Metacore defense. Anyways, that's all for the Lakers. Milwaukee beat Philadelphia 105-90. And now for your NCAA football. Vanderbilt beat Ole Miss 27-26. Memphis beat Tulane 37-23. Southern Methodist beat Southern Miss 34-6. UCF beat UTEP 31-24. Notre Dame beat Boston 21-6. And Brigham Young beat Idaho 52-13. And finally, number 2 Oregon blew California out 60-17. That's all for today. Before I go, I want to give a shout out to the veterans, especially Rocco. Everybody, let's take a moment of silence for them. Okay, now to Janaya.
Thanks, Marion. Okay, time now for your daily 411.
Wow. What are babies turkeys called? Cubs, chicks, grubs, or poults? Take 5. It's chicken, guys. Mm-hmm. Poults. Baby turkeys are called poults.
Wow, nice, Marion.
What?
Let's give more size to the veterans.
Okay.
Never
mind.
It's passive.
And I said a moment. I didn't say multiple moments.
Anybody got shout outs to give?
I got one for Michael.
I got one for everybody who wanted a shout out. And once again, Rocco. And I'm not sure if that was Mr. Morgan's son or Mr. Morgan, but shout out.
I got to Rachel and Kimya. Okay. So visit our website to watch today's broadcast online at 115show.com and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube at 115show.
That's all for our show. We'll see you back here tomorrow.
Yep.
Yeah.